Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. So, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. Today we are going to discuss a lot of interesting questions including the Atmanirbhar Krishak Development Scheme. And as always, I have very interesting fact in the end of this video which is kept in the GK Factory section. So, if you want to know what is that interesting fact, then you have to stay here till the end of this video, okay? So let's begin, but before that let me inform you all that you can download this PDF through the Telegram channel that we have, and the link of our channel is in description below. So the very first question that we have is, which state has approved the Atmanirbhar Krishak Development Scheme? Uttar Pradesh, Madhya Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Maharashtra are in the options, out of which Uttar Pradesh, guys, is the right answer. Now, before moving into the details, let me tell you that this Atmanirbhar Krishak Development Scheme is nothing but the scheme to develop the FPOs in the state of Uttar Pradesh. FPOs stand for Farmer Produce Organizations. Now, we all know that these farmer producer organizations are being created in order to strengthen the farmer cooperatives, in order to increase and we can say double the income of the farmers by the year 2022, which is just around the corner. So in order to achieve these targets, in order to strengthen the supply chain mechanism, in order to have the infrastructural facilities post harvest, okay, because we know that majority of our food produce is lost after the harvesting of the food. So in order to have the post harvest infrastructure, warehousing, cold storages, so that the food production would not go in vain, this scheme has been launched in Uttar Pradesh. Now, it is basically a sub-scheme, we can say, of Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. So, we will be discussing about that fund also, but that was a glimpse that I wanted to give you of this scheme before moving into the details of the scheme. So, now let's go into the details. First of all, this will have the same tenure as of the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. That is from 2021 to 2022. Okay. Next is that under this scheme, 1475 farmer producer organizations are going to be established in the state of Uttar Pradesh. Your question is that tell me how many farmer producer organization is the central government aiming to establish across India. Okay, moving further. Central government has allocated rupees 12,000 crore fund to the Uttar Pradesh government to utilize under the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. Now, this scheme is basically a sub-scheme of that, because in order to utilize this fund that has been given to Uttar Pradesh under the Agriculture Infrastructure Fund, the state government of Uttar Pradesh has launched this scheme. I hope that now it is clear to you. So basically, there are two objectives of the scheme. First, to establish FPOs, and second, to give loan for creating the post-harvest infrastructure facilities. So the overall expenditure of the state for this particular scheme is rupees 1,220.92 crores, which is not required by you all to memorize. Okay, so you can very well skip this number, but do not forget to know this number, rupees 12,000 crore. It's a huge sum that has been allocated to the state. So this point I have already discussed with you. So do not forget to mention the answer of the question that I have asked from you, the number of FPOs that the government is aiming to establish. Which bank has launched the Chola Sarva Shakti policy? Equitas Small Finance Bank, Karnataka Vikas Gramin Bank, Bank of Baroda, Paytm Payments Bank, Karur Vyasa Bank. Guys, here the right answer is option A. Equitas Small Finance Bank has launched this Chola Sarva Shakti policy, which is basically a women centric policy, or women centric we can say feature, or the facility that this bank has launched. Now what we have in this facility, let's discuss that. So first of all, for this policy, Chola Mandalam MS General Insurance Company has also partnered with this Equitas Small Finance Bank. Now it is a women specific health insurance policy that is being offered by the Equitas Small Finance Bank. So a bank is offering this health insurance policy in partnership with the Chola Mandalam MS General Insurance. So this is basically a kind of bank assurance. I hope that you all are aware of this term, bank assurance agreement. So this bank assurance agreement is basically an agreement that is arrived upon by a bank and an insurance company to sell the insurance to the bank's clients. Okay, so we all know, we all go to our bank branches, and nowadays it's become a race. So there is one person who is after you to sell the insurance policy, or many a times the advisors advise you to have an insurance policy that will also have saving benefits for you, like saving investment benefits for you. So that is the kind of bank assurance, okay, wherein the bank is selling you the insurance policy. So the Chola Seva Sarva Shakti is a women centric or women specific health insurance policy to empower Indian women with good health and finances. Now the benefits that will be provided to the holders of this policy are accident and health insurance, maternity expense insurance, child education support, EMI option in case of termination from job on grounds of ill health. So be it the permanent termination or be it the temporary termination from the job on grounds of ill health, the policy holders will be provided with the option of paying EMI. Okay, so these are the some of the benefits that are provided to the women under the Chola Sarva Shakti policy, which is basically a life insurance policy. Sorry, health insurance policy, not life insurance. Question number 3 here is, with which IIT has Indian Air Force signed an MOU for various developmental projects to support the requirements of Indian Air Force? So here we have IIT Kharagpur, Delhi, Ropat, Roorkee, Madras. The right answer is IIT Delhi. So both IIT Delhi and Indian Air Force, both of them have partnered, signed this MOU to develop various kinds of innovative solutions so that they can boost the indigenization. Boost indigenization refers to developing the weapons that are needed by the Indian Air Force within our own country. So that is the whole crux of this MOU. Next question is, which state has signed the record of discussions with Japan International Cooperation Agency for prevention and control of non-communicable diseases in the state? Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Nagaland, Assam, Mizoram are in the options. So here the right answer is Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu and Japan International Cooperation Agency, both of them have signed a record of discussions, basically an agreement for cooperation for prevention and control of non-communicable diseases in the state. So this project will strengthen the managerial and technical capabilities of health personnel with respect to NCD prevention and control. So here what do we get from these two statements? That one thing is that there is a partnership that has been held between the Japan International Cooperation Agency and Tamil Nadu state government. And second important fact that you should keep in mind from exam perspective is that the purpose of this cooperation is to build the capacity of the health personnel of Tamil Nadu. Now, what kind of capacity? The capacity to manage and to respond to the NCDs, non-communicable diseases. Because we all know that non-communicable diseases are a very big threat to life. Okay, so let's see what the international organization like UNICEF has to say about the non-communicable diseases. So according to UNICEF's data, the death rate of NCDs is 63% of all deaths, and the probability of death from NCDs between the ages 30 to 70 is 23%. So this precarious is NCDs. Okay, NCDs are very dangerous to health. So this organization has been supporting the Tamil Nadu Urban Healthcare Project through its overseas development assistance. Now this project was launched many years back, and since then JICA has been supporting this project of the state of Tamil Nadu to improve the quality of urban healthcare services by developing the health facilities. Next question is, which state has partnered with UN Capital Development Fund's Global Center for Financial Health for ensuring economic empowerment of women? So here Odisha, Kerala, Rajasthan, Gujarat and Punjab are in the options. So the right answer here is option A, Odisha. Now basically under this partnership, Odisha and UN Capital Development Funds Global Center for Financial Health. So basically the organization, the very head henko of this partnership is the Global Center for Financial Health, which operates under the UN Capital Development Fund. Now guys, what this UN Capital Development Fund is and what is this center, I have discussed this in detail in the static GK course, so I'm not taking it up again for this time. Maybe I will pick this topic again when we have leisure time in order to discuss it in detail, but right now let's focus on the current news that we have. So as far as this news is concerned, so both of these agencies are going to establish the Mission Shakti Living Labs. Now what is the purpose of this lab? So the purpose would be to empower the women by creating awareness among the women regarding the financial health, regarding the financial sources. For example, how to better plan your finances, how to manage your borrowings, how to manage your savings, and how to spend better and cautiously. So all of these awareness will be spread among the women by using the digital technologies and e-commerce tools that are available. So eligible beneficiaries of this Mission Shakti Living Lab initiative are the self-help groups and the households majorly run by the women. Okay. The next question is, how many problem areas are being tackled by the Animal Husbandry Startup Grant Challenge 2.0? So here the right answer is 6. A total number of 6 problem areas are being tackled through this startup grant challenge. So for second edition of this challenge has been launched by the Ministry of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy Farming. The purpose is to find innovative and commercially viable solutions to address the 6 problems faced by the animal husbandry and dairy sector. The prize money is rupees 10 lakh for the winners and 7 lakh for the runner-ups for each of the problem areas. The challenge is available on this website, which is the website of Startup India. So these were the facts from where the probable questions can be made in your examinations like RBS Abhi Nabad. So I have put all of those important facts here in this slide. Now is the time to move to our GK Factory section. So guys, the sea or the lake that I was talking about is the Aral Sea. Now, first of all, do you know where is this located? Aral Sea is basically a lake. It is a lake, not a sea. First of all, it is located at the border of Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan. So this is the only lake that I was talking about that is shrinking, and it has now shrunk by 90% of its volume. So only 10% of its volume is now remaining. So what are the reasons for its shrinking? Before telling you that, let me tell you that this sea was a very beautiful sea. It was counted as the world's 4th largest inland lakes, okay, the 4th largest lake before 1960s, but by the time 1960s came, the lake started to shrunk. Now what were the reasons that I'm going to tell you, but first you need to know that it is an endorheic lake. So here I'm giving you a new term, I'm acquainting you with a new term. I hope that you majority of you who did not know about it would be glad to know this fact. So endorheic lakes are those lakes which do not fall into the sea, which do not meet the ocean. So endorheic lake, endorheic rivers, all of these are the sea bodies which do not meet the ocean. So I hope that now you are striking the chord in your mind regarding a river that I told you in the last class in the Thar Desert, which is an example of endorheic river, which does not meet the Arabian Sea. So which river is it? It's the Luni River, right, which goes from the Thar Desert to Gujarat, run of Kutch. It does not meet the Arabian Sea. So it is an example of endorheic river. So I have discussed this. Now, this is, guys, the result of human greed. In 1970s, this was the area of Aral Sea. I told you that by the time 1960s came in, the sea started to shrunk. So by 1970, this was the area, and by 2014, this is the remaining area, as you can see. So presently, 90% of its area has shrunk. The only the remains are left, that too are in the forms of patches. which you can see here clearly. Okay. Now, first of all, you need to know what are the sources of water of this lake. Obviously, every lake has their sources, be it the rainfall or the rivers that are draining that lake. So, this lake, which was the fourth largest, its basin was the was two rivers, Amudarya River and Shirdarya Rivers. So, these are the two rivers which you can see. So, this one is the Amudarya River. Okay, so it is going from Kyrgyzstan. Sorry, this one is the Shirdarya River. It is going from Kyrgyzstan. Then we can see it is there in Tajikistan. Then it is there in Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan also. So it is touching Uzbekistan. So this Shirdarya River has four countries from where it is flowing. Then this is Amudarya River, which is flowing from Tajikistan. Then Afghanistan also, it has some area. Then it is covering the area of Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, and then it is going into this Aral Sea. So you can see that both of these rivers are giving water to the Aral Sea. Now that you know that what are the sources of its water, you will be easily able to understand the reasons for the seas shrinking, for the lakes shrinking. So the reason is that the waters of these seas have been diverted for ages for the water intensive crops, okay, like rice, like cotton. So in order to grow these crops, the waters of these rivers were diverted by the USSR. So by 1970s, it was a part of USSR, Soviet Union. So at that point of time, the water was diverted and it has been continued like that. Nobody tried to rectify the situation. But before 1960s, before it's completely drying up, it was a very rich habitat. It was a habitat of rich marine life. Okay, right now, since it has been drying up, so there is no traces of rich marine life. Rich chodo, ab to normal marine life bhi nahi hai, and human life is also getting impacted due to the shrinking of the Aral Sea as well as the ecological impact that the shrinking has. So this is the region where Aral Sea is present at this moment of time, at present, okay, Kazakhstan and Uzbekistan's border. So right now, the Kazakhstan government, as I have told you, that it has now remained in patches. So right now it is divided. Northern part of this Aral Sea or lake is in Kazakhstan and the southern part is in Uzbekistan. So the Kazakhstan government has taken the initiative to revive this lake by the help of World Bank. So they are creating a dam on this lake so that the water can be provided. But the Uzbekistan government is not keen to revive this lake. And you would be shocked to know that the Uzbek government is hell-bent on boosting its cotton industry. At the present moment also, Uzbekistan is diverting majority of the water to the cotton producing areas, okay? So guys, here is the sad story of Aral Sea. So this was the scene in 1960s and right now it is the 2014 area. So Uzbekistan government or the country of Uzbekistan is the 8th largest producer and the 11th largest exporter of cotton in the world, okay? अच्छा अब वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट सो मच ऑफ द अराल सी लेट मी गिव यू अ ग्लिम्स ऑफ द सी लेवल इफ यू डोंट इवन रिमेंबर द सी लेवल इट्स नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू टू नो बिकॉज दिस इज द सेक्शन वेयर आई ट्राई टू गिव यू सम इंटरेस्टिंग फैक्ट्स अबाउट द इंटरेस्टिंग प्लेसेस एंड द अननोन प्लेसेस दैट वी हैवंट नोन सो द सी लेवल ऑफ दिस अराल सी हैज डिक्लाइंड फ्रॉम 53 मीटर्स विच वॉज देयर इन द फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ 20th century, that is till 1950s. It was 53 meter of the sea level, above the sea level, and by 2010 it was 27 meters, and 27 meters in the large Aral area that you can see here. This is the large one, and small Aral had 43 meters above the sea level. Okay, now this is also a part of Aral Sea. Do remember this is all Aral Sea. So guys, all these were the facts related to Aral Sea, and this is showing the greed that is eating up, I would say gobbling up, the environment right now. So it's high time that we should take action एवरी वन ऑफ अस कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट अ लिटिल बिट टूवर्ड्स एनवायरमेंट. लाइक वी कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टूवर्ड्स द एनवायरमेंट बाय नॉट यूजिंग दी सिंगल यूज प्लास्टिक्स टू द एक्सटेंट दैट एवरी हाउस होल्ड थिंग ऑफ आवर्स इज कमिंग इन द प्लास्टिक बैग्स. सो वी कैन रिड्यूस दैट थिंग. ओके, सो इन स्मॉल मैनर्स वी कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टूवर्ड्स एनवायरमेंट. यू कैन फाइंड आउट योर ओन वेज हाउ यू कैन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टूवर्ड्स रिड्यूसिंग द इकोलॉजिकल डैमेज. ऑन दैट नोट आई वुड लाइक टू एंड दिस सेशन. थैंक यू सो मच गाइज फॉर वॉचिंग इट. डू टेल मी हाउ डिड यू लाइक द फैक्ट्स, हाउ डू यू फील अबाउट द जी के फैक्ट्री सेक्शन, डिड यू लाइक द फैक्ट्स दैट आई टेल यू अबाउट द एरालसी. ऑल्सो यू कैन गिव मी सजेशंस अबाउट सर्टन थिंग्स दैट यू वॉन्ट टू नो, आई विल टेक अप इन द जी के फैक्ट्री सेक्शन. ओके, थैंक यू सो मच गाइज फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो.